my chain. So transporting pots is usually a difficult logistics approach, so most of the people don't do that. So when you are going to deliver wet mass to a centralized location, you need to take into account the duration. You can deliver up to 10-12 hours wet mass, but the longer it takes, the better your transport equipment should be. So that's why if it is short distances, the cacao can be transported in a bucket or it can be transported in a sack, etc. But like in Nicaragua, when we were working with Ingeman, we established a very complex model just because we want to guarantee this consistency. So Ingeman is still driving out with the fermentation boxes on a truck. So they run the route and every farmer delivers in a short distance from their place. So between a window of 2 hours, their cocoa in a bag or in a bucket, but then it passes immediately to the big fermentation box. Like this, you already pass the cacao to the right environment. But that's also a difficult logistics system and of course makes everything a little more expensive. But in most cases, and now because the road systems have become better, you can still deliver within 5-6 hours to the centralized fermentation location without any problem in a bag. But of course, once the wet mass arrives now, you need to have quality parameters to judge the freshness of the wet mass that comes in. Because if you start accumulating wet mass from different days harvested, then your fermentation, of course, is not going to be as consistent as well.